Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is The Nation Wants to Know on Times Now. I'm Ankit Tyagi. Very quickly, going across to the top story that we are tracking at this moment. Breaking his silence on AIMIM chief Asaduddin Owaisi's Shaheen Bagh threat. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath warned of strict action if any people's sentiments were stirred on CAA. Addressing a BJP booth-level event in Kanpur, Adityanath termed Owaisi as a Samajwadi Party agent, a B-team for the SP, and said UP was on track to be riot-free.
हम मोदी जी को भी बताना चाहेंगे, बीजेपी को बताना चाहेंगे कि जिस तरह आपने किसानों के लिए ये तीन कानूनों को, कृषि कानूनों को वापिस लिया, हम आपसे इस बात का डिमांड करते हैं कि CAA कानून को भी वापिस लिया जाए। उस कानून, उस फंडामेंटल राइट के खिलाफ कानून बनाया गया और हम मुतालबा करते हैं कि CAA कानून को भी वापिस लिया जाए। अगर NPR और NRC का कानून बनाएंगे तो हम दोबारा रोड पे निकलेंगे, यहीं पर भी शाहीन बाग बनेगा इंशाल्लाह ताला। याद रखना, हम खुद आएंगे यहाँ पर
उस व्यक्ति को जो यहाँ पर सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट एक्ट के नाम पर फिर से भावनाओं को भड़काने का कार्य कर रहा है। और भाइयों बहनों, मैं इस अवसर पर चाचा जान और अब्बा जान के अनुयायियों से कहूंगा कि वे सावधान होकर के सुन लें। अगर प्रदेश की भावनाओं को भड़का करके माहौल खराब करोगे तो फिर सख्ती के साथ सरकार निपटना भी जानती है।
Joining me now on the broadcast, Anila Singh of the Bharatiya Janata Party. We also have Danish Qureshi, political analyst, who is joining us this evening. Thank you so much to both of you for joining us. Anila ji, just wanted to understand, is this what the election of Uttar Pradesh is going to look like? Is this just the trailer? From Shamshan Kabristan now to Shaheen Bagh, will people actually hear real issues, or is that the entire politics that we are going to hear from here on?
My Ram Ram to everyone. And Ankit ji, we want to discuss on development, because the amount of work which Yogi Adityanath ji's government has done in Uttar Pradesh, that is remarkable and excellent work he has done in UP. But the problem is, when Lehra comes from Hyderabad and starts dancing and singing here and starts saying that I am going to make Bharatiya Janata Party government dance on my tune and I will tell them to remove, to scrap off CA as well, so then definitely we have to react. And the type of phrases and words Lehra uses here in his speech, so do you think that we are going to sit very calmly?
Ma'am, you are addressing a political leader as a Lehra yourself, and then you are talking about the kind of phrases somebody else is using. But is the answer Abba Jan, Chacha Jan? Is the answer, because you know, a lot of people would say that it works for both of you, for Owaisi as well and for BJP as well. Use these terms, throw it in the election mix, polarize the entire election. It works for you, it works for him.
See, first of all, I didn't coin this name. He himself loves to call himself as Lehra. Did Anila Singh of Bharatiya Janata Party coin this name to Owaisi? No, he himself did that. हंस हंस कर बोलते हैं जब भाषण देते हुए कि मैं तो लैला हूँ, मेरे मजनू बहुत हैं। फिर कभी ये बोलते हैं रजिया घिर गई गुंडों से। भारतीय जनता पार्टी तो नहीं कह रही ना, जब अपने आप को लैला कहलाना पसंद करेंगे तो हम भी उनको लैला कहना पसंद करेंगे, क्योंकि जो उनकी इच्छा है उसका मान करना चाहिए उस इच्छा का।
और लैला के साथ हम अब्बा जान, चाचा जान ले आएंगे, हम चाचा जान ले आएंगे, क्योंकि दानिश कुरैशी, ऑपोजिशन, यू कीप सेइंग दैट उत्तर प्रदेश राइट नाउ इज पोलराइज्ड, योगी आदित्यनाथ इज वर्किंग, हैज नॉट डन एनीथिंग, दिस इज द बेस्ट टाइम फॉर द ऑपोजिशन टू हाईलाइट all the shortcomings. Instead, we are only talking about CA, NRC. Are these the issues that the election will be fought on?
Remember one thing, Ankit, I think that Baba has lost the confidence for Uttar Pradesh election. That's why he's speaking like Abba Jan and Chacha Jan and all that. The thing is very clear that he has threatened as a chief minister of Uttar Pradesh that those who are the follower, remember one thing, what did he has stated that ke chacha jaan aur abba jaan ke jo anuyai hai, they are not a religious leader, they are a political leader. Hmm. Those who are the followers of this political leader will be threatened hard by the state. Why he wants to threat to the voters of the AIMIM and SP? The Election Commission of India should take the cognizance.
Election Commission of India should take cognizance. But tell me, Danish Qureshi, tell me, Danish Qureshi, is this blackmail politics going to be the way forward? Is that the only way that you see going forward as far as AIMIM is concerned? Shaheen Bagh bana denge. What does that even mean?
Ankit, I want to reply to Anila Singhji. What Anila Singhji was saying before.
Sir, reply to my question, then reply to what Anila Singhji is saying.
Same manner. I will reply your question in the same manner that wo apne aap ko Leela kehlana chahte hain. If he wants to say that about CNRC, you don't want to respect that theme of Asaduddin Owaisi, but you want to respect as a Leela. So ye jo dual standards hai na Anila Singhji Bharatiya Janata Party ke, that is problematic.
Sir, lekin
you have to come out from that.
But you agree that this is only blackmail, you know, protest blackmail that is going, that is taking place right now. You are only making sure that you try and arm twist the government and tell them either accept our demands or we will create protests. We will make sure that anarchy prevails.
Ankit, protest is the part of the protest is the heartbeat of democracy. How you can say that anybody is doing blackmail? Even each and every citizen of the country has a right to protest against the government if he or she thinks
sir,
that decision of the
totally
government is
respect,
not proper.
I totally respect the right of the citizens to protest, but not use protest as a threat. That is what Mr. Owaisi is doing. But Anila Singhji, you have brought this upon yourself. Now, after you've gone back on the farm laws, there are people, those who will keep coming back at you, not only for CANRC, they do believe that Prime Minister Narendra Modi's entire macho image has taken a beating. They think that the BJP can be put in a corner with protests and make sure that they go back on the laws that they have enacted.
Let them say, if they think that they are going to corner Bharatiya Janata Party or NDA government, and they will be able to pressurize government to scrap off CAA, then they are suddenly mistaken. Yes, constitution has given them this right that they can go ahead, they can do any sort of agitation without taking law in their hand. Especially if I talk about my state, Uttar Pradesh. We have a Bhagwa Dari as a chief minister. And the strength of the Bhagwa is that he has made a policy that if you are going to create ruckus, if you are going to take law in your hand, and if you are going to damage private public property.
But unless you'll agree that Prime Minister Narendra Modi's image has taken a beating, like you were saying that they are mistaken, they think that they can force the government to take these laws back. 1 year back, the farmers were possibly also mistaken that they thought that this will happen. It actually did. That too with an apology.
Kindly do not compare Leela and his team with the farmers. No comparison at all. Unko kehne dijiye unse kehne se kya hota hai. Kali ek ladka mara gaya hai Pakistan mein jiske sath dushkarm hua, fir uski hatya kar di gayi. Leela chup kyun baithe hue the?
I'm very glad, ma'am, that finally the BJP and the spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party have at least come to the point where they acknowledge the people, those who are protesting as farmers, after giving them all sorts of name. But Danish Qureshi, Asaduddin Owaisi is desperately trying to find a foothold as far as the politics of Uttar Pradesh is concerned. Many people are calling it, and you would understand the phrase, Noora Kushti, that BJP and Asaduddin Owaisi will keep calling each other names so that at least the opposition space is shrunk and Owaisi is seen as one of the prominent face.
Ankit, I want to reply you of this question that you can see Anila Singhji, how he is replying to Asaduddin Owaisi. Did you think that if anybody is having alliance or hidden alliance or anything can treat like this? Have you ever seen in the parliament, each and every session which the bill or act are being enacted by the central government, every time Asaduddin Owaisi has took the charge against the government to represent the citizen of the country. But the thing is, I think the repeal of the farm law is the political decision of Mr. Modi, and farmers are not having faith in that. Although BJP knows very well, and even farmer knows very
Sir,
well.
Sir, we'll see whether farmers have had any faith in it or not, and whether, and in fact, how it plays out in the upcoming elections of Uttar Pradesh. But one thing is very clear: the opposition is missing out on a golden opportunity to, in fact, go to the voters and expose if they believe that the government of the day in Uttar Pradesh has not done enough work. Rather, they are possibly walking into a trap set by the BJP, talk of everything but the issues of the people. Thank you so much to both of you for joining us here on this face-off on Nation Wants to Know.